In my previous movie about stability, I already hinted that there were some really cool upcoming new features in the 1.3 release. Well, the release was released yesterday, so let's do a movie on those cool new features. I want to start with modeling of rigging. Well, modeling of rigging was already possible, obviously, as I showed in back in January, in this really cool, crazy rigging movie, but it was quite cumbersome. Why? Well, for example, consider you want to insert a shackle pin inside the eye of a pet eye, and the eye is a little bit larger than the pin of the shackle. So you basically have something like this. You have the, well, not really to scale, but you have the eye of the pet eye, and you have the pin of the shackle. And basically you want that pin to be able to move all around the inside of that eye, and you also want it to be able to rotate. So how would you previously model that? Well, we could do that. You could say, hey, I add an access system to the center of the eye. So I make a new access, call it eye center, and I place it at the same position as this point of interest, which is 256. So 256. There we go. And then on that pet eye, or on that access system, you create a second one which can rotate. So create a new axis called rotating, well, let's call it shaft, because that's basically what it is. And you enable that, or you free that in rotation about the y-axis. So now if I would place this second circle on that rotating shaft, and actually rotate it, then you can see that it moves along the outside of the pet eye. So the next thing, because we want the shackle to be able to rotate as well, is to at the location of this point of interest on the rotating shaft attach another axis system which is again able to rotate, and then finally attach the shackle to that second rotating axis system. So that really makes kind of a mess of your model with all those nodes, and it's a lot of work, which you, well, maybe you want to do it once, but if you have five different shackles, you there is an easier solution. So what I did, I implemented an overall node called a manager. Well, why would an engineer invent a manager? Well, because it cleans stuff up. What these manager nodes do is they can control a group of other nodes. And let me show you what I mean. Let's say I create a shackle. Let's take a big one. Okay. Inside that circle. Solve statics. There we go. So now we have a management node. And basically what it does, it creates a system similar to the one that I just set up here with all those axes, but it hides it. So this is the management node. It's called GP1000 or Greenpin 1000 connection. And basically it connects the big circle to the pet eye. Let me make the geometry size a bit smaller. Let me hide the COG. So now we can actually see it. So we have the PedEye pin here, which is connected to this enormous PedEye eye. Sorry, the shackle pin connected to that enormous PedEye eye. There's a small checkbox here saying show all managed nodes. I will check it for now. And this shows all the nodes that have been created by that manager, and they manage the connection between this big circle or the big PedEye eye and the shackle pin. And I cannot change them individually because they are managed by the manager. So it's actually this text tells that. And if I select the manager, then the manager exposes some of the properties of these nodes. So in this case, I can control, let me hide these. So the manager controls the position of this shackle in the circle. So if I change it, the shackle will rotate. And I can fix it, or I can free it. And it also controls the rotation of the shackle itself. And there's also a swivel option. Good thing, I can also delete managers. So if I want to release the shackle from the PedEye, I can simply go to the connection and say delete. And it will delete all the managed nodes. And it will maintain the shackle. So the shackle is still here. Now for this geometric contact, as it's called, there's two options. You can use it for an inside contact, or you can use it for an outside contact. So let's say I want to connect the bow of the shackle to this circle. I can select the bow, or the circle that's in the bow. I hold shift, select the big circle. And I say connection using circle as master. Well, that's what I want. Need to give the name contact. That's fine. Okay, so we have now created a contact between the big sheaf and the small circle here. And by default, it's an outside type contact. So I can change between inside, which puts the small circle inside the big one, kind of modeling a pin-in-hole connection, or I can put it on the outside. So now it's difficult to see, but it actually touches the outside of the other circle. Well, it doesn't make much sense. If I solve statics, the shackle will fall down, and it's kind of a magnetic-like contact. So this I shouldn't use it in this way, obviously. So let's change it to inside. How I can use it, of course, is for pin-on-pin contact, or pin-on-bow, or solid-on-solid. For example, if I want to insert a second shackle below this one, I can say create. Well, let's do a 900 tons shackle. Okay, so we now have a 900 tons shackle here, and I want to connect the bow. Oh. I want to connect the bow of that shackle to the pin of that one. Let me hide the C. So what I can do is I can select both of them. And then I can say connect using either this one as the master, or this one as the master. If we want to use this one, so the bow as a master, you can see that this button is actually red. And it is because if I would use this one as a master, then it would slave this shackle to this shackle. But this shackle is already slaved to the circle. So that would break this connection. It's possible, but it's, well, use it with caution. Another and maybe easier way of doing this is by dragging and dropping. I can just select the bow here, or the circle in the bow, and I want to connect it to that pin. So what I can do is I can just select it and drag it onto the pin, and will automatically create a connection. Well, geometric connection showed up here. And in this case, I indeed want to use an outside contact, so pin on pin. So if I solve it, it ends up at the wrong position, because this was the easiest equilibrium position to reach. Because remember, there's just one solid rod between those two sheaves. So this is a valid position. What I want to do is I want to change the side with this button here. Now this looks a lot better. And if I solve statics again, it ends up at the right place. So that's it for shackles and geometric contact. Another element that was difficult to model was a sling. And a sling is basically, let me just show it, create sling. A sling is basically a lot of elements, a lot of nodes. It is a, where did it go? No, it's there. Let me delete that one. Let me just create a point of interest here, or point, as it's called now. Point. And just select it, select the point, select the sheaf, create sling. This is what a sling would typically be. It's a cable here, going around a sheaf. It's a body representing the splice, so the spliced part where the sling is spliced back into itself. Then there's a part of the main body. Then there's another splice here. And finally there's the other eye. So this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements, or main elements, a number of points, and 2 visuals, ending up, well, in this whole bunch. So what we did is combine it into one single managed node, which is basically managing exposing all the typical properties of a sling. So you have the total length, you have the total stiffness, diameter, there's a mass, and you can control the individual lengths of the eyes and the splices. And of course it will only show when you actually solve it. So this is what we have created. Slings of course can also run over sheaves, or over shackles, or over points. And the interface of that has also gotten a small update. So let's add a new point. Yes, position it somewhere. Well, let's put it there. What I can now do, if I want this sling to run over this point, I can just select the sling. Oh, by the way, if you want to select a managed node, you can, the first time you click onto something, it will just select that node. And then when you click on it again, it will select the manager. So what I want this sling to run over this sheaf. I'll make the total length a bit bit more. So what I can do is I can just drag this point. Let's call it point 2, which is here. Point 2, and I can just drag and drop it in between the endpoints of the sling. And as you see, the sling now runs via this point. That's it. That's the basic functionality that is implemented in version 1.3 using managed nodes. Of course, these managed nodes can be used for a lot more. Actually, they can be used for any standard group of nodes. So let's say you are a vessel operator and you have your vessel, and your vessel is composed of, well, maybe 50 nodes. You may want to create a custom manager just for your vessel, in which you can, well, only easily expose some of the properties that you frequently want to change, such as crane slew, crane radius, maybe enable or disable different blocks or different revings, those kind of things. And well, it has the potential to make your models a lot cleaner. Okay, and of course it makes rigging or designing rigging a whole lot easier, because as you saw, we now have this rig it right screen here. If I press escape to deselect all, then it gives me all the available shackles. I've only added the green pin heavy duty shackles for now, and if I can just click one, and it pops up a small window asking for the name, and it instantly creates one when I hit enter. There it is. What I can also do is, when I select a circle, it gives me the option to create a shackle inside that circle. Or what I can also do is, if I select one or more circles or points of interest, then it gives me the option to either create a sling over all these sheaves or a cable. So in this case, I've just easily created a standard cable. And for the cables, we have the same easy drag and drop interface now for organizing the order of the connection points. So let's say I want to change the order. I can just drag and drop this one, and now the sling goes like that. Okay, well, there's a lot more I want to tell you, but I want to keep this video below 20 minutes, or at least reasonably short. The other big update is on reporting with JupyterLab, but I will do a different video on that. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them in the box below on YouTube or on the openocean.org website. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time.